What other challenges can we expect on the way to healing our inner child? Once we are aware of our filters or our defense mechanisms, the next step is to find the way to let go of them and live without them. Example, a woman might realize that she has a trust issue because she was abandoned by her father in childhood. She knows that it is extremely hard for her to trust men and other people in general. She knows how to criticize men. She knows how to compete with them. She brings huge expectations into the relationship, and she truly wants to find a partner and create loving, caring relationships, but subconsciously she sabotages her intention. She might act like she is not interested in men. She might not show her affection during the date. She might question everything that man says or does. She might find thousands of errands and convince herself that she does not have time for dating. Her fear of being hurt and left alone is so big that she might not even realize it. She might not truly see how she sabotages her relationships. She comes to therapy and says, like, I really want to find a partner. I really want to be happy. I'm tired of being alone. But when a good man comes into her life, she won't believe them. She might simply ignore him or not even notice his attempts to flirt with her. But she will always be on alert and notice players and bad guys. She will always see this negative behavior towards her and ignore the good guys. So this way she will kind of reinforce her filters and stay unhappy. I recommend you to watch my free webinar, which is called Obstacles to Love. And I talk about this a little bit more in detail in that webinar. So just check the description in this video, and I will include this webinar as well. Where should we start our healing journey? Our inner child behaves like real children do. Kids don't want to take responsibility in life. They expect that somebody will always do things for them. Therefore, you can ask yourself, where do I expect a miracle in my life? Perhaps you have a belief that one day you will find your Mr. Right or Mrs. Right, and then you will be truly happy. So you're making your own happiness depend on somebody else. Another example, a woman is looking for a rich husband because she does not want to work. And this is another childish desire that my daddy will buy me everything, will make me happy, and I don't have to do anything. I just have to smile and be beautiful. A third example is a parent who is making, let's say, 12-year-old child to take care of a toddler. A parent is making the 12-year-old child to change diapers, feed and play, and babysit the child. Or a mother who does not spend time with her kids, does not teach them, does not play with them. Has an expectations that her kids will become smart, responsible, and successful adults. To answer the question, where should we start our healing journey, I would recommend to notice what words you're using and start noticing words like no one, everyone, everybody, never, always, why me, why in my life, why in my family, this is not fair, why this time of year, why this happens specifically when I decided to do this, this, and this. Our inner child loves using these words. Our inner child loves to complain. And when our inner child complains, it gives him an excuse to avoid responsibility. I recommend to start noticing these words in your family members and friends, and then little by little you will begin to notice it in yourself. It's not easy to notice it in yourself right away, because when we are in the specific emotional situation, our emotions are overwhelming us. We are not in control of our emotions, so we cannot notice our thoughts and our words. But we can do it with our family, friends, and members. So start with them, and then little by little you will begin to notice it in yourself, and this will be for you a starting point to heal your inner child. Are there any other signs or red flags that can help us to notice our inner child? Yes, there are. We just spoke about paying attention to words. It is the easiest way. The hardest way is to notice our inner child actions. Let me give you some examples. For example, people who are always late. People who need to be reminded several times about completing tasks. People who complain a lot about politics, the economy, taxes, or about other people. Here we can add people who have a hard time following rules and authorities. People who don't take care of their body, exercise, or eat healthy. One of the biggest signs of a wounded inner child is the inability to manage your own emotions. I talk about emotions a lot in my videos. I have another free webinar that I would recommend you to watch. The webinar called Tell Me What You Eat and I Tell You What Problems You Have. In this webinar, I talk about how to identify what emotions you're trying to suppress with food. For example, when a person is angry and trying to suppress his anger, he is drawn to hard food like nuts, chips, crackers, meat with the bone, chicken wings. So when you're angry, you want to crush something, you want to break something. That's why you can be drawn to hard food. Or another example, when a person is trying to suppress feeling of loneliness, often we are drawn to specific type of food, to specific type of ice cream, or to specific cuisine. We want to eat maybe some specific sausages, so we feel lonely. We have this loneliness or longiness for a specific person. That's why we're drawn for a specific food. And the food and the person might not be related to each other, but this is the algorithm, psychological algorithm, how we suppress our feelings. And of course, when people don't take care of their body, don't exercise, it's also a signal, a red flag about the wounded inner child. Because kids, they don't want to count calories, they don't want to exercise, they don't consider food if it's healthy or not. They just want to have fun, they want to have their pizza, hot dog, cake, mac and cheese, drink soda, and have fun. If you tell a child, you know, this is the third piece of pizza and you already ate a lot of calories, a child will look at you strange. He won't understand your words, and for a child, it does not really matter if he ate 1,000 calories, 2,000 calories, or 3,000 calories. Again, you can find all webinars that I mentioned in this video in the description of this video, or you can just go to YouTube channel and type Psychology of Happiness, Elena Semenek, and you know, you will see my channel and all the webinars will be there. What steps would you recommend taking to heal the inner child? Today I would like to share with you 7 great techniques that will help you to heal your inner child. Number 1 is guided meditations, and specifically guided meditations. Lots of people don't know how to meditate, and if I tell you, you have to close your eyes, relax, you know, and think about the healing energy that comes to you, in 99% most people will get tired of this after first 2, 3, or 5 minutes. So I recommend guided meditation, when a person is guiding you through the process, when you are not just meditating, but when you are following a person's voice who is guiding you and helping you to work on one problem or another. And on my YouTube channel, I have several free guided meditation that you can listen for 21 consecutive days. And it should be consecutive days. 21 is the minimum amount of days that we need to develop a new habit, to develop a new belief, or to develop a new behavior pattern. And those guided meditations will help you to connect with your inner child and to give your inner child the love, support, and protection that he needs. The second technique that I would like to share with you is to pay attention to your thoughts. Your thoughts are your beliefs. That's why I was talking about noticing words that you are using, such as nobody, ever, always, of course, this is a common sense. So when we generalize the situation, when we generalize people, then it might be a signal or that your inner child is wounded, and this might be a signal of the situation that you need to explore deep in details, right? So think, pay attention to your thoughts and ask yourself, what do I really feel right now? Do I really want to do this? Self-awareness is the greatest tool to connect to your inner child. It's not the easiest, but it's one of the greatest technique. If you can master it, you will be able to notice your inner child and to connect and to heal your inner child. So tool number two is pay attention to your thoughts and ask yourself a question. What do I really feel right now? What do I really want right now? Technique number three is to take care of your body. As simple as this, exercise 2-3 times a week. Start eating healthier food. Start maybe walking, running, doing stretching. In Russia, I'm Russian, and in Russia we have a saying, a healthy soul lives in a healthy body. All our limiting beliefs, all our mental blocks create stress and tension inside in our body. By stretching, by working out, you can start releasing those physical blocks from your body. And you will actually feel more free and happier once you will do this as a daily routine. Once you're gonna take care of your body, you will notice that you will, your posture will change, your the way you walk will be different, the way you present yourself to the world will be different. So your self-esteem will go up and you will be able to heal and to connect to your inner child. You will give him this confidence, this feelings of I'm good, I'm worthy, my life is protective, I can achieve anything. Number four is to have a hobby in life. Think about what did you like to do in your childhood. Maybe you have some unrealized dreams that you can easily achieve right now. Think about what do you like to do right now? What makes you happy? What do you really enjoy? Perhaps you like hiking. Maybe you like fishing. Maybe you like reading a book, bicycling. Maybe you like making art. Anything is good. Just allow yourself to have things that you really, really enjoy in life. Allow yourself to have a hobby. This way you will experience more positive emotions like happiness, joy. You will laugh more often. You will have these feelings of excitement, and all those feelings will help to heal your inner child. Even without going through like deep pain inside, you can help your inner child just by having a hobby in your life. Technique number five, how to heal your inner child is to learn new things. When we learn new things, we're gaining new experiences in life. And those experiences make it easier for us to move forward from the past. With new experiences, we meet new people, we expand our knowledge. It can be anything from a desire to learn a new language, or maybe a desire to learn about nature, about new cuisine, maybe about new culture. Perhaps you like to read and you have not been reading a book for a while, or maybe you always wanted to learn how to play tennis or a musical instrument, or maybe you always wanted to try scuba diving. New things bring new skills, new experiences, new people, new situations, new opportunities in your life. Number six, how to heal your inner child is to check my free webinars on YouTube and learn more about this topic. Being aware, by gaining information, by learning about the inner child, about our emotions, self-esteem, money, relationships, you will better understand yourself. You will understand other people better, and you will be able to understand yourself, why you did this, why did you make this decision in your life, why did you choose this partner, and again, you will develop your self-awareness, and self-awareness is one of the greatest tools in your journey of healing the inner child. And number seven is to work with a therapist, is to find the professional person, a mentor, a therapist, an online psychologist, life coach, a person who can guide you through this process of healing your inner child. There are lots of different exercises and methods for doing this. A good therapist, a person who knows about the inner child, can choose a method that will be the best for you, that a method that will be the best for you to heal your inner child. And of course, a therapist can provide the emotional support, the love, the protection, the knowledge that your inner child really, really needs. Again, if you have any questions, please write them in the comment section below. If you don't ask your questions, I will not be able to help you. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Please help me to spread out the word about Psychology of Happiness, about my channel, and share this video with your friends and family on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, via email. And I'm looking forward to seeing your questions, to seeing your likes, to seeing your shares. Again, my name is Elena Semenek. I'm an online psychologist and a life coach, and this is my YouTube channel, Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. I release 2-3 videos every week, so subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you next time. Bye.